Good morning, everybody, and welcome to the Royal Swedish Academy of Sciences and this press conference. The Academy met in session this morning to award this year's Nobel Prize in Physics, and we are now ready to announce it. My name is Göran Hansen. I'm the Secretary General of the Academy. And with me on the podium today are two members of the Nobel Committee for Physics. On my right, Professor Mats Larsson, who is the chairman of the committee, and on my left, Professor Ulf Danielsson. And as usual, I will read the announcement, first in Swedish and then in English. I will also read the citation in German, French, and Russian. Mats will make some remarks about the Nobel Prize, and Ulf will introduce the science behind the prize. And after that, we hope to have one of our new Nobel laureates with us on a phone line, and there will be opportunities for questions. Ready? This year's prize goes for contributions to our understanding of the evolution of the universe and Earth's place in the cosmos. Årets pris belönar bidrag till vår förståelse av universums utveckling och jordens plats i universum. Kungliga Vetenskapsakademien har idag beslutat att utdela 2019 års Nobelpris i fysik med ena hälften till James Peebles för teoretiska upptäckter inom fysikalisk kosmologi. Och med andra hälften gemensamt till Michel Mayor och Didier Queloz för upptäckten av en exoplanet i bana kring en solliknande stjärna.
Discoveries about our universe. The last few decades have brought remarkable progress in our understanding of the development of the universe and Earth's place in it. Cosmic background radiation was for the theoretical discoveries of James Peebles. The wonderful high-precision measurements of this radiation over the last 20 years. Since then, more than 4,000 exoplanets have been found. Recently, Earth-like planets with the potential to host life have been discovered. Professor Ulf Danielsson will now describe these exciting discoveries in detail.
I know what happened before then, but after a little less than 400,000 years of expansion, the universe had cooled down to a temperature of a few thousand degrees. Galaxies started to form. But it's only 5% of the energy in our universe, which is in the form of ordinary matter like stars and planets and living beings. One can compare our universe to a cup of coffee. Most of it is, of course, coffee. This is the dark energy. Then a fair amount of cream. This is the dark matter. And then just a tiny little bit of sugar. This is the ordinary matter. This is what science has been all about for thousands of years.